Hello students, how are you? Everything good? I am teacher Anuja from the Wave Private School. Today we are going to learn about identification of ions and gases. This topic is for grade 9. You will find this topic from Cambridge IGCSE chemistry course book. Let us proceed with the chapter. The main objectives are identification of aqueous cations. Then we are going to see test for cations, then identification of aqueous anions, then test for anions, and last we are going to see identification of gases, and then we will check test for gases. Students, you know cations and anions. Cations means positive ions and anion means negative ions. Let us proceed next. Identification of aqueous cations. Now students, see, in any solution whether cations are present or anions are present, that we understand by its change in color. Okay, so for metal cations in aqueous solution, it can be identified by the color of the precipitate they form when there is addition of sodium hydroxide. So what is sodium hydroxide? That is NaOH. And ammonia, that is NH3. So it says when there is a solution and the solution changes its color when there is addition of sodium hydroxide and ammonia. So by that we can understand the presence of cations. So see the next. If only small amount of NaOH is used, then normally the metal hydroxide precipitate. What is precipitate? Precipitation means there is the solid formation develop which is not soluble in liquid. Okay, so that part is called precipitate. Okay, a few drop of NaOH is added at first and then color change is observed. Okay, so first they put small amount of NaOH and then they observe the color change. Or during that there is a formation of precipitate also. But if we put more NaOH, the reaction is observed and sometime precipitate may dissolve. Now see student, in this they say like we have to put very drop wise drop NaOH, but if we put more, the precipitate which is forming, it may get dissolved. Let us see some example. These are some example of cations. Cu2+, that is copper. Fe is iron with 2+ oxidation number and Fe3+. This is say third 3+ oxidation number. Okay, now let's see for copper. Now see student, when we put 2-3 drops of sodium hydroxide in this solution, first you can see in this test tube there is copper solution. Then when we put 2-3 drops, then it becomes light blue PPT is occurred. Okay, see there is a formation of PPT, that is light blue. And when we put excess of sodium hydroxide, you can see the PPT disappears. Okay, but the solution gets little more darker as compared to this. Meanwhile, if we put ammonia, you can see this. The solution color also changes and you can see the presence of PPT is so visible. And in this second, you can see there is excess of ammonia. So there is no formation of PPT and PPT disappears and the solution becomes dark blue solution. Got the difference? The presence of cations when there is addition of sodium hydroxide and ammonia. Let's check for iron. First, see, you can see the color, it is colorless, but when you put 2-3 drops of NaOH, it is green PPT. When you put excess, the PPT dissolves, it is not visible, it becomes clear solution and you can see it becomes little lighter green. Meanwhile, with ammonia, the color, it becomes dirty green PPT. Okay. And when we put excess, you can see the color becomes less green and the PPT gets disappear. Now let's see for iron with oxidation number 3+. When we put 2-3 drops of sodium hydroxide, there is formation of reddish brown PPT. You can see the PPT formation. Okay. So when we put excess, the PPT disappears. Similarly with ammonia, when we put ammonia in Fe3+ solution, you can see this orange PPT is formed, reddish brown PPT, and when we put excess, the PPT disappears. So you got the point, student. On standing in air or oxygen, the dirty green PPT of FeOH2 that turns reddish brown due to oxidation of Fe to ions. See here, they have given one example. See, if we keep this Fe ion in air, you can see the PPT is there, and when we put more excess of NaOH, this becomes dirty green. Okay, so the color of solution containing Fe3+ may range from colorless to pale yellow depending on concentration of ion. So this also depends on concentration of ion. Let's see test for cation. Before I go to test for cation, let me give you some exam tips. Now see, student, the ammonia or sodium hydroxide solution must be added very slowly. Okay, if we add too quickly, then the precipitate is soluble in excess, then you run the risk of missing the formation of the initial precipitate, which dissolves as quickly as it forms if excess solution is added. Got it? If you add very quickly, then the formation of precipitate is missed. Okay, you cannot get the PPT. So you have to put the solution of ammonia or sodium hydroxide slowly, drop by drop. So let's see their test. We saw the test for cations. Now we will see how to identify which element or atom is present in the solution. So for that, they have flame test. Okay, so what it is, the flame test is used to identify the metal cations by the color of the flame they produce. So you can see in these two pictures, student, you can see there is different flame, different color of the flame. So what they do, a small sample of a compound is placed on unreactive metal wire such as nichrome or platinum. So this is the wire. On that, they put small sample of the compound and then they put near the flame, and you can see there is change in color of the flame. It is absorbed, and then they identify which metal it is. You can see in this first photo, when they introduce this metal wire to near flame, there is yellow flame, and in this you can see there is violet flame. Got it? Now similarly, they have different colors for different flame. Let's proceed to next. Now see, student, you can see in this the different colored flame produced by the metal cations during flame test. You can see this first, this is lithium, so it has pink color. Okay, in second you can see sodium, it has yellow color flame, whereas for K, that is potassium, it has purple color. Okay, and for fourth you can see that is calcium, it has red color flame. For copper, they have green color flame. Got the difference, student? How to test the cations by flame test? So they take one metal wire, they put small amount of compound, and they introduce that wire to flame, and you can see the change in color of flame. Got this concept? Let us proceed for test of anion. Identification for aqueous anions. Now we will see for anions. So what are the anions? That those are carbonates, chloride, bromide, iodine. So this chloride, bromide, iodine, they come under halides. Okay, that is halogen group. And next is nitrite, sulfate and sulfide. So what are the tests? These are the tests, and we see the observation as this. Okay, we will see, observe this in next page. with example. So for this we will perceive what are the exam tips. So when it comes to qualitative inorganic analysis, always remember that there will be a test for metal cation part of the molecule and the other test will be for an ion. Got it, students? So whenever it will be for qualitative inorganic, the first test will be for cation and the second will be an ion. Let us see now with example. Now see, student, first you can see this test is for carbonate. So when carbonate, in that when you add dilute acid and there is dilute acid, you can see this, and this acid is there, then they turn lime water as milky. Why? Because there is effervescence of carbon dioxide. Okay, so this test is for first carbonate. When you add dilute acid, you see carbon dioxide produces, makes the lime water cloudy or milky. Next test we will see for the halide group. See, this is chlorine, bromine and iodine. So in this, you can see in this test tube, in this three test tube of halide, when we add dilute nitric acid, we see in chlorine there is white precipitation formation. In bromine there is cream color precipitation forming, and in iodine there is yellow precipitation formation. So got this point, student? Now let's see for sulfate. Now see what is for sulfate. When we add nitric acid and aqueous barium nitride, we see white PPT. Let's check. See, student, you can see here the formation of white PPT. So these all test examples are for test for anions. Let us see for gases. This is last, and that is identification of gases. So there are several tests for anions and cations which produces gases, which then need to be tested. Exactly which gases are they? Either they are ammonia or carbon dioxide or chlorine gas, hydrogen gas or oxygen gas or sulfur dioxide. So before we see this test, let us see some examples. So from that example you will understand. So see, first is test for carbon dioxide. Okay, so what it is, the appearance is, of course it is colorless. So what happens, there is bubble of carbon dioxide in water, in which the lime water turns milky. So when lime water turns milky, we see that there is presence of carbon dioxide. Let us see for chlorine test. So for chlorine test, the appearance is of pale green. Okay, so there is pale green color appearance and it has choking smell. So what happens in this? The damp blue color litmus, it changes to red color, and after that it bleaches to white color. So you can see the blue, it is changed to green, and then afterwards it changes to white color. Got it? Let's see for hydrogen. So when there is hydrogen gas develop, so it gives pop to the matchstick. You can see a squeaky pop with lightened splint. Okay, so it is for hydrogen gas. Let us see for water. So when we put a blue litmus paper, when we put under water, you can see the color change from blue to pink. Got it? So that test is for water. Let's see for oxygen. So when there is oxygen gas, the pop-up matchstick, when we bring close to test tube, it gets off. So that says for oxygen. Let's see for chlorine gas test. So these gas tests appear regularly on final exam, and then we have to try it. Okay, so got it, students? So these are the tests for gases. So this was your end of topic. Thank you.